Circumstances have changed.
After shifting positions on the Hyde Amendment before a campaign visit to New Hampshire, former Vice President Joe Biden said Thursday it's time to repeal the ban that prevents federal dollars from funding most kinds of abortion.
We now see so many Republican governors denying health care to millions of the most poorest and most vulnerable Americans by refusing even Medicaid expansion. I can't justify leaving millions of women without access to the care they need and the ability to exercise their constitutionally protected right.
Biden's reversal comes amid efforts to limit abortion in some states and as the issue gains traction in the Democratic presidential primary.
He was under a firestorm from Elizabeth Warren, Bernie Sanders, Kamala Harris, et cetera, et cetera.
Senator Jeanne Shaheen says she's glad to see movement within her party toward a more unified position against the Hyde Amendment.
Well, I've been opposed to the Hyde Amendment since it was first introduced. I was pleased to see the vice president change his mind on the issue.
Shaheen has voted for budgets including the Hyde Amendment in the past, but expects it will be removed if Democrats are able to regain control of the Senate and White House.
What we're talking about is really restricting who can get health care and who can't. And I don't think that's what Americans want.
And it's certainly not what reproductive rights groups want. Planned Parenthood of Northern New England tells us it's heartened to see a growing number of candidates take this step.
The Hyde Amendment is discriminatory policy because it blocks people, particularly low-income women and women of color, from receiving access to safe legal abortion care.
Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.